Dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Bhaskaran, assistant professor from University of Delhi. Today we are going to discuss about the module Introduction of Scanning Tunneling Microscopy under the paper Surface Analytical Techniques. In introduction part, first we will talk over history of scanning tunneling microscopy and how it originates. Then we will discuss about the basic principle involved in STM, tunneling current and tunneling effect, comparison of STM with ordinary and other microscopic techniques, comparison between STM and AFM. After, we will talk about the various application of STM. After completing this module, we will understand history of STM, STM principle, tunneling current, application and advantages and disadvantages of STM. A scanning tunneling microscope is an instrument for imaging surface at the atomic level. Its development in 1981 earned it inventors Jed Benning and Heinrich Rohr at IBM Zurich the Nobel Prize in Physics in 1986 for an STM. Good resolution is considered to be 0.1 nanometer lateral resolution and 0.01 nanometer depth resolution. With this resolution, individual atom within material are routinely imaged and manipulated. The STM can be used not only in ultra high vacuum but also in air, water and various other liquid or gas ambients and at temperatures ranging from near 0 Kelvin to a few hundred degree Celsius. The STM is based on the concept of quantum tunneling when a conducting tip is brought over near to the surface to be examined. A bias voltage difference applied between the two can allow electrons to tunnel through the vacuum between them. The resulting tunneling current is a function of tip position, applied voltage and the local density of states LDOS of the sample. Information is acquired by monitoring the current as the tip's position scan across the surface and is usually displayed in image form. STM can be a challenging technique as it requires extremely clean and stable surface, sharp tip, excellent vibration control and sophisticated electronics, but none at unless many hobbyists have built their own, written by Jed Benning and Heinrich Rohr, is the basic patent of STM. STM experiments with atomic resolution are always performed with very short tip sample distance. Direct measurement have shown that the normal tip sample distance in STMs are 1 to 4 angstrom before a mechanical contact. The experiments were simultaneous measurement of the force gradient and the tunneling conductance in an STM. By integrating the force gradient, the point of a mechanical contact is determined. The tunneling conductance as a function of the tip sample distance with respect to point of a mechanical contact is directly measured. At a tunneling conductance of 1, the distance is found to be about 1 angstrom from a mechanical contact. The tunneling current varies about 1 order of magnitude per angstrom. Therefore, the normal tip sample distance in STM experiment, typically with a tunneling resistance of 1 megaohm to 1 gigaohm, is 1 4 angstrom from a mechanical contact, the transport process in the distance range of normal STM operation is very different from the tunneling process is the classical tunneling junction, where the thickness of the insulator between conducting electrode is typically 20 to 30 angstrom. First, because of the overlap of the surface potential of the tip and the sample, the top of the potential barrier in the gap region is substantially lower than the vacuum level. In many cases, the top of the potential barrier is even lower than Fermi level. Second, the local atomic structure and the local electronic structure near the gap region play a dominant role. Third, the focus between the tip and sample, both attractive and repulsive, are important. The force deforms the tip and the sample in the vicinity of the gap region, a tangible effect on the tunneling current is often observed. Surface characterization microscopic technique of STMs are there. Here, principles. In these techniques, the surfaces of the solids to be studied are swept in a raster pattern with finely focused electron beam or a stable probe. Importance of raster scan. This gives the three-dimensional images of the surface, and three common techniques are namely SEM. The surface of the solid is scanned with the electron beam, and number two, SPM. The surface is scanned by a very fine metallic probe. Here, SPM are of two types: STM, scanning tunneling microscope, and AFM, atomic force microscope. History of STMs are there, developed by Jude Binning and Heinrich Raher at the IBM Zurich Research Laboratory in 1982. Their first experiment using STM involved imaging structure of a crystal of gold. STM is an instrument for imaging surface at the atomic scale level. Their discovery opened a new era of surface science, and their impressive achievement was recognized with the award of the Nobel Prize in Physics. It is based on the concept of quantum tunneling. This invention was quickly followed by development of a whole family of related techniques, which together with STM may be classified in the general category of scanning probe microscopy. Of these latter techniques, the most important is atomic force microscopy, shortly called AFM. The two shared half of the 1986 Nobel Prize in Physics for developing STM. STM has fathered a host of new atomic probe technique: atomic force microscopy, scanning tunneling microscopy, magnetic force microscopy, scanning acoustic microscopy, etc. Here, briefly, scanning probe microscopy are divided into scanning tunneling microscopy and atomic force microscopy. And scanning tunneling microscopy is the device that can image the surface of conducting materials with atomic resolution. This is the important for various reasons. Firstly, the STM has an atomically precise positoning system which allows very accurate atomic scale manipulation. Furthermore, after the surface is modified by the tip, it is very convenient to image the sample with the same tip without changing the instrument.
IBM researcher developed a way to multiple genome atoms adsorbed on a nickel surface. This technique has been used to create electron corals with a small number of adsorbed atoms, which allows the STM to be used for observing electron fractals oscillations on the surface of the material. Apart from modifying the actual sample surface, one can also use the STM to tunneling electrons into a layer of electron beam photoresist on a sample. In order to do lithography of the sample, this has the advantage of offering more control of the exposure than traditional electron beam lithography. Another practical application of STM is atomic deposition of metal, gold, silver, tungsten, etc., with any desired pre-programmed pattern, which can be used as a contact to nano device or as nano devices themselves. Variable temperature STM was used to investigate temperature dependency of molecular rotation on single crystalline surface. Rotating molecules appear blurred compared to non-rotating surface. This figure shows in the slide depict the STM microscopic images. STM has a very high resolution of 0.1 nanolateral and 0.01 nanometer depth. It is used only under ultra-high vacuum condition at temperature ranging from 0 Kelvin to over 1273 Kelvin. Vacuum tunneling of electron from tip to sample can take place even in the environment in the region surrounding the tip is not a vacuum but is filled with molecules of gas or liquids, with a tip sample spacing as small as 5 angstroms. There is little room for molecule even though they may exist in the surrounding atmosphere. The scanning tunneling microscopy can operate in ambient atmosphere as well as in high vacuum. Indeed, it has been operated in air, in water, in insulating fluid, and in the ion solution used in the field electrochemistry. It is much more convenient than ultra-high vacuum instruments. When a high vacuum environment is employed, its purpose is not to improve the performance of the scanning tunneling microscope, but rather to ensure cleanliness of the sample surface. The STM can be cooled to temperature less than 4 Kelvin. It means minus 269 degrees Celsius or minus 452 degree Fahrenheit, the temperature of liquid helium. It can be heated above 973 Kelvin or 700 degree Celsius or 1300 Fahrenheit. The low temperature is used to investigate the properties of superconducting material, while the high temperature is employed to study the rapid diffusion of atom across the surface of the metal and their corrosion property. The electron required for the STM are extremely sophisticated as well as very expensive. Low cost and relatively low quality STM start at approximately $8,000. However, some group of researchers have actually built their own amateur STMs for much less than that amount. However, professional quality STMs can range anywhere from $30,000 to $1,50,000 $ depending on the manufacturer and the extra part and application included. Here, basic principle of STM is the surface of the sample is scanned in the raster pattern by a very fine tip. The tip is maintained at the constant distance above the surface throughout the scan. The up and down motion of the tip then reflects the topography of the surface. In order to maintain the tip at the constant distance from the sample, a tunneling current between the tip and sample surface is monitored and held at the constant level. Here, tunneling current is generated by the voltage that is applied between the tip and the sample as shown in figure. It is based on concept of quantum tunneling. When a conducting tape is brought very near to the surface to be examined, a bias voltage difference applied between the two and allow electrons to tunnel through the vacuum between them. The resulting tunneling current is a function of tip position, applied voltage and local density stage of the sample. Information is acquired by monitoring the current as the tip's position scan across the surface and is usually displayed in the image form. STM is a challenging technique as a required extremely clean and stable surface, sharp tip, excellent vibration control, and sophisticated electronics. The electronics required for an STM are extremely sophisticated as well as very expensive. Firstly, a voltage bias is applied and the tip brought close to sample by closer sample to tip control, which is turned off when the tip is sample are sufficiently close. At close range, fine control of the tip in all three dimensions. When near the sample is typically piezoelectric, or maintaining tip sample separation typical in the 4 to 7 angstrom, or we can say 0.4 to 0.7 nanometer range, which is equilibrium position between attractive and repulsive interaction. In this situation, the voltage bias will cause electrons to tunnel between the tips and sample, creating a current that can be measured. Once tunneling is established, the tips bias and position with respect to the sample can be varied, with the details of this variation depending on the experiment, and the data are obtained from the resulting changes in current. Tunneling current is the current that passes through a medium that contains no electrons. Tunneling current becomes significant when two conductors are within a few nanometers of one another and one of the conductors is in the form of a sharp tip. Magnitude of the tunneling current is given approximately by this formula. Here, V, bias voltage between the conductor, constant that is characteristics of the composition of the conductor. D is the spacing between the lowest atom on the tip and highest atom on the sample. The tunneling current is held constant by feedback mechanism that moves the tip up and down so that D remains constant. Tip movement is controlled by piezoelectric transductor. From the above equation, we can say that the tunneling current decreases exponentially with the distance between tip and the sample surface. This decrease in tunneling current with the distance causes the tunneling current to become significant only at small tip sample separation, thus leading to high resolution in STM. The STM makes use of this extreme sensitivity to distance. The sharp tip of STM is positioned a few angstroms from the sample surface. A small voltage is applied between the probe tip and the surface, causing electrons to tunnel across the gap. As the probe is scanned over the surface, it registers variations in the tunneling current, and the information can be processed to provide a topographical image of the surface.
Many other microscopy techniques have been developed based upon STM. These include photon scanning microscopy, PSTM, which uses an optical tip to tunnel photons, scanning tunneling photometry called STF, STP, which measures electric potential across a surface, spin polarized scanning tunneling microscopy, SPSTM, which is used ferromagnetic tip and tunnel spin polarized electrons into a magnetic sample, and atomic force microscopy, AFM, in which the force caused by interaction between the tip and sample is measured.
What is electron tunneling or tunneling effect? According to classical physics, a particle of energy less than the energy of a barrier could not penetrate. The region inside the barrier is classically forbidden for the electron. According to quantum physics, particles exhibit wave-like behavior. This wave represents the probability of finding the particle in a certain location, meaning that by applying a certain energy, it is possible that some part of this particle wave crosses the barrier. This behavior is called tunneling. This slide explains the tunneling effect in STM, which shown in figure. Classically, if one threw a ball at a brick wall, they would always find the ball on their sides of the wall quantum mechanically. However, the ball has some finite probability of tunneling through the wall. The more energy the ball has, the more likely it will be to tunnel. Direction of standing wave pattern of copper plus 3. Here, the STM images show the direction of standing wave pattern in the local density of states of the copper plus 3 surface. These spatial oscillation or quantum mechanical interference pattern caused by scattering of the two-dimensional electron gas of the iron atom and point defects. Comparison of STM with other microscopy techniques. An ordinary microscope employs optical lenses that can view objects smaller than the wavelength of light. On the contrary, an electron microscope could view smaller things with greater clarity than an optical microscope, but have a disadvantage of viewing individual atoms. Thus, STM was developed in order to view atoms with higher resolution. Gradual refinements in the instrument improved the precision, noise, and design, resulting in clear image formation. The sharp tip in the STM is similar to that in the scanning electron microscope, SEM, but the difference in the two instruments are profound. In the SEM, electrons are extracted from the tip with the series of positively charged plates placed a few centimeters downstream from the tip. The electrons at the apex of the tip are confined to the region within the metal by a potential barrier. The attractive force from the positive charge on the plate is sufficient to permit the electron to overcome the barrier and enter the vacuum as free particles. the apertures in the downstream plates from an electron lenses that converts the diverging beam from the tip into a beam converging to a focus on the surface of the sample. In the STM, the plates that form the lens in the SEM are removed and the tip is positioned close to the sample. The electrons move through the barrier in a way that is similar to the motion of electrons in a metal. In metals, electrons appear to be freely moving particles, but this is an illusion. In reality, the electrons move from atom to atom by tunneling through the potential barrier between two atomic sites. In an ideal case, with the atom spaced 5 angstrom apart, there is a finite probability that the electron will penetrate the barrier and move to the adjacent atom. The electrons are continuous motion around the nucleus. The electron approach the barrier with the frequency of 10^17 per second. For each approach to the barrier, the probability of tunneling is 10^-4, and the electron cross the barrier at the rate of 10^13 per second. This high rate of transfer of electrons means that the motion is essentially continuous and tunneling can be ignored in metals. Tunneling cannot be ignored in the STM. Indeed, it is all important. When the tip is moved close to the sample, the spacing between the tip and the surface is reduced to a value comparable to the spacing between neighboring atom in the lattice. In this circumstances, the tunneling electron can move either to the adjacent atom in the lattice or to the atom on the tip of the probe. The tunneling current to the tip measures the density of electrons at the surface of the sample, and this is informed is displayed in the image.
Comparison of STM with other microscopic techniques. STM instruments has a capability of pushing and pulling individual atom around, resulting in manipulation of objects of that small by humans. After the discovery of STM, Binning in 1986 discovered atomic force microscopy in order to examine the surface of materials that were not electrically conductive in nature.
In this slide, difference between STM and AFM has been discussed. In STM, it captures images using quantum tunneling effect, but in AFM, captures images using nanometer sized tip moving over the surface. And other hand, in STM, the probe is not in direct contact with the surface of the specimen, but is kept at the shorter distance. And in AFM, the probe makes a direct contact with the surface of the specimen. Here, in STM, it measures tunneling current, but in AFM, measure small force between surface and the tip. And STM has lower resolution as compared to AFM. In AFM has higher resolution as compared to STM. STM is the applicable only to conducting sample, but AFM is applicable to both conductor and insulator. And now in STM operates under ultra high vacuum, but in AFM does not need ultra high vacuum to operate.
So students, let's summarize all the content that we have studied today. Scanning tunneling microscopy, STM, was developed in 1981 by Jared Benning and Heinrich Rohr at IBM Zurich, and got Nobel Prize in Physics for this invention in 96. The first experiment using STM involved imaging structure of a crystal of gold. STM is an instrument for imaging surface at the atomic scale level. STM work on the concept of quantum tunneling. Quantum tunneling or tunneling is a quantum mechanical phenomena wherein a particle tunneling through a barrier, the atoms escape the surface of the solid specimen, forming an atomic cloud hovering over the surface. As the other surface approaches, there occur an overlapping of atomic clouds and an atomic exchange takes place. The discovery of STM instrument opened the doors toward various fields of research, like in nanotechnology, electrochemistry, semiconductor science, and molecular biology. STM has a very high resolution of 0.1 nanometer lateral and 0.01 nanometer depth. It is used only under ultra high vacuum condition at temperatures ranging from 0 Kelvin to over 1273 Kelvin. In STM, a tunneling current is generated on application of voltage V that is applied between tip and sample surface, and its magnitude is given the following equation. The tunneling current decreases exponentially with the distance between tip and the sample surface. This decrease in tunneling current with the distance causes the tunneling current to become significant only at small tip sample separation, this leading the high resolution in STM. STM provides a detailed image of the structure of the specimen. It is used in studying friction, surface roughness, defects, etc. It is also widely used in determining surface reactions in materials. It is very important tool in research, particularly in the field of semiconductors and microelectronics. Thank you.